Ballard's pretty new, okay? Wasn't really thinking about the automobile.
Yeah, but this is not just Washington, this is every community.
But I'm concerned with the village.
I know, what I'm saying, you're making it sound like they only speed on Ballard Pond or.
No, they speed on Carlisle.
They speed on everywhere, yeah, so.
There's people on Carlisle, like, come in one end and they go out the other end, because they think it's a through street, that's okay on Lincoln.
But I don't have sidewalks or curbing, they actually come up my lawn when they're going around the corner, all right, if you wanna complain. They come up on my lawn to go around so fast.
So, you know, let's,
Fill out an.
I should put huge rocks.
Yeah, fill out an incident.
Fill out an incident, okay?
And.
So when you put that sign, you're putting it right in front of my house.
Okay, so what is the procedure now that we wanna, go on this?
Well, I guess first is the legality, and then we'll discuss it further. Do we really want it or not, or just do it, cause an enforcement?
I like that.
The sign, slow them down.
I like that. All of, I tell you, you go on West Street in Warwick, it's 25, and they have it there, left and right. Most people do 25, I put my cruise control at 25, I wanna go down West Street, because they're always there. Right on Pond Hill.
You guys are there.
Right now, we're at Decker and Liberty, the guys do.
We're at Decker and Liberty.
They do stop sign details every day, they change it to different areas, they're assigned based on complaints, so like I said, right now, they're at Decker. Last week, they were on Cardinal and Peacock. You know, a lot of tickets were issued just for that intersection.
Really, Cardinal, for the stop sign?
Yeah, Cardinal and Peacock is a heavy hitter for tickets, it's just, I think they're leaving and they just go. Most of those people, I can't say, majority of them aren't village residents, leaving the village or coming into the village for whatever reason, but the ones on Decker, that's all village residents.
Oh, yeah, it's people that live there. People are gonna do that where they live, because they're comfortable.
Okay. So we'll, get more information on this for next Tuesday. And we'll set a meeting, public hearing on that. Come up with, public hearing meeting on Tuesday. And see if we have a special meeting between next Tuesday and next month's work session.
You gonna have a public hearing on Tuesday? Is that what you just said?
No.
I don't think we can schedule it, it's not enough time, we need 5 days.
Yeah.
But it could be put in the post, on Friday.
I think you should wait till you talk to Will, before you go.
What do you wanna know?
What are you talking about?
Just say next Tuesday, wouldn't it be the Tuesday after that? Between.
No, the third Tuesday.
No, the meeting is next Tuesday.
First Monday, third Tuesday.
Right.
So it would be the 15th.
Yeah.
Okay.
Because it was an early month.
Got it.
First came early.
So can we schedule a public hearing on?
You have to have 5 days from publication.
That's a week from tomorrow, can't.
Okay, so what is the next work session? Unless we have a special meeting.
Something.
Next work session is June 4th.
Yeah.
Do we wanna have a special meeting before that?
Well, then I guess it all depends on what Will says, and then. If Will says it's okay, are we all okay with having it? If Will says it's okay.
That placing a stop sign then?
Yeah.
I'm fine with it.
I'm more towards Paul's opinion, because then where do we stop?
Yeah.
Then another neighbor complains somewhere else, and then.
I mean, that started a whole bunch of stuff. I wish you would have come to the board before that was done. thought of a whole bunch of, still have questions. Why are they coming? Why are they there?
Well, they receive calls today, she said.
We get calls every day for a lot of complaints, and, I mean, you know, we'll just act spontaneously on every incident report we get.
Well, that's what we're supposed to do.
If it's legal.
Well, we still have to entertain it. We just can't say no.
Yeah, but you have to talk to us, to the board.
We don't want to do.
What if I decide to go put up a yield sign on Somerset tomorrow? I mean, I can't, I'm not going to do that.
Where is Somerset?
Wherever. You know? It's got to be a board decision.
It has to be a board resolution. Okay, so.
We wanted to have a board resolution to pick the colors of the Princeton police station.
Yeah.
So we should have a board resolution to put up stop signs.
Right, so that's why the stop signs are covered.
Stop signs.
All right, painting the village police station, speak to that.
Oh, look at the colors. Right, you see, and this is why I wanted to have the board here, so he's not hanging out.
Is that trim or the whole building?
Diane was there.
Yeah, okay. So he's not hanging out by himself.
Yeah, that choice or this choice. These are the two choices.
I like the yellow.
This would be the...
What is the yellow?
I know. I like yellow. I think yellow should be there.
This is a joke. Let's take them off.
Are you looking at... You actually thought?
Yeah,
which, those were the colors?
Oh, I was like, seriously? You got the lime green?
See why?
I feel like I'm in my alley.
This would be this. This is what we're proposing as the color of the building itself. And this would be the accent up on top, which is the darker shade. Marie and I were down, spoke at Parade for a while this morning. Diane came in, happened to come in at the same time. But Parade really thought these colors would go good. The red brick, the white doors, the red handrails. They got three estimates. One guy doing his finest painters. His name is Chris. He was the first recommended person from Corinne. He's local, retired police officer, I think, in New York City. And he was a lot cheaper, well, with a better grade paint. And he started today just power washing some of the building.
Okay. Now what about like the window track?
The window's white. It's white, the red brick is staying red, and the call box and the handrails will be just basically a rubber division. The red, pretty similar to what it is already. All the paint will be purchased at the local hardware store. And trying to get the whole building done as quickly as he can, but promise to get the front done for Memorial Day. So.
One of the things I spoke to Val on was coming up with the design for the sign, eliminating the internally lit sign. It's not backlit, internally lit sign. And actually removing the sign above the door, Washington Building,
right.
DARE program.
Right.
We don't have DARE anymore. I don't think we need anything else but that sign. And that's maybe where that other design comes in, with the... let's say D. Okay, because there's not going to be a sign underneath that. So we could we have electric out there. If prices on either lights coming down from the top, lights coming up from the bottom, we have to decide that how we want. You know, we have to set the stage for if we're asking other businesses to do what we want. We have to set the stage for it.
Are you agree with all that? Then what happens if they're just going to remove the police station?
That's fine. The person who owns that building would use that same, they have to change the sign, obviously, but that's the sign that they would, the area that the sign would be.
You mean the one on the street?
The one on the street.
So it would just be plastic with lights on it, not like a real wood sign with engraving and everything?
Whatever. Everyone decides.
Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Because the village entrance signs are going to be very nice. They're going to invite you.
No, I see what you mean. So it could be plastic.
I want to buy one and throw it away a year later.
No, it could be plastic.
Yeah. I'm okay with that.
Yeah. But removing the sign, so would the painter do that on the building?
I'd ask Artie to do it. Oh, up on top, you can remove it. When you paint it, I can ask him to remove it.
If not, the DPW could go to remove it. Probably have to remove, they're not gonna paint around it.
Yeah, we don't want to paint around it.
Be interesting, though, to see what color it is underneath the sign, yeah. Because something tells me somebody painted around it.
I think they said the last time it was painted was about 26 years ago.
Wow.
Last we heard. Inmates had painted it at least 26 years ago.
Yeah, he's not painting the brick.
No, the brick is being, he's just doing the windowsills white, the doors white, the handrails are film rails, and the coil box will be red.
They look low too. One's broken.
Yeah, we gotta get them in the glow and change them to, I wanna change them to green.
Yeah. We'd have to vote, or yes? Because we already approved it, just the color, right? Is that what we're
waiting on? Yeah, we have to.
Formal vote?
Formal vote, okay. On the painting of the, formal vote on the painting.
Do you have the name of that company so we can?
Finest Paints, I'll double check it.
Somebody wanna present the motion?
What, to paint the police station?
Yeah.
Sure.
With using Finest Paints?
Sure.
I'll second it.
All those in favor?
Aye. Lime green, you said, right?
4-0, with these colors.
Oh, these?
Oh, okay. There's an F to the chief.
I have the following ones, don't I?
I just gave you contractor's invoice. This was for 33 East Main Street. If you pass that house right now, there's no debris on the porch. There's none in the back, both side, both properties leading to the back has been cleaned out. I saw Ed McLaughlin down there on Sunday and asked him to remove the 2x4s that they put the plastic on. So he cleaned up the porch.
Yeah, I was thinking the same thing, yeah.
I don't know if that was done yet.
No.
I mean, this was Sunday, but as I was there, a worker came down worker came down from the roof, so chimney's down, sealed up. Now we have to take it one step further. No, no rodents at all.
Because the neighbor sent me an email.
Yeah.
Asking about it.
Yeah, she sent me the same one, I believe. It's coming from the creek.
Okay.
There was nothing underneath there. There is an oil tank there. I don't know if we want to tackle that, but I think right now, because that house is just one big something horrible to happen, we need to now ask Will to draw papers for a warrant so they could go into the house and we can start cleaning the house out. Okay. So I'll talk to Will on that too. Hopefully we could sell the house, or they could sell the house, it's not my house, they could sell the house. And according to Jeannie, the warrant would be issued from the courts here. So we'll have to go to the courts. Okay.
Do you want us to sign off on it?
Sure. Yeah, I'll prepare it tomorrow.
Okay.
This is... I had the pleasure of meeting with the DDC today.
Yeah.
Joe Fong, was that the gentleman who came down? The two pictures represent one on April 2nd and one just last week. The one from last week is, we have to make a decision. That drain pipe runs through the woods. And what could be the cause of it, correct me if I'm wrong, Chris, or if you want to talk about it, it's tree roots.
Yeah, tree roots have gone into the sewer main. There's like a clog. And caused a major backup for the whole entire system, all the way to that field. And County, Modena Creek over here. So DEC needs to see something being done with it, and you know, that you guys are moving towards something, because it could result in a lot of money for the
So one of the ideas were to, on the pathway to the future dog park, to put a whole new drainage pipe in there. Talking to John Petrosini, the engineer, we might be able to just cut down the trees, leave the stumps, okay, so the trees aren't going to grow anymore, and then just put a sleeve in the pipe. After we get it cambered by somebody. So that's the first step. We need to see what
conditions
the conditions and how far that is in.